Hello everyone and welcome back to the last anniversary special review of this year's Doctor Who month. And it's only fitting that this comes out on the 57th anniversary of Doctor Who, so happy anniversary everyone! So the Five Doctors was really the Doctor Who anniversary special for many years. To me, Day of the Doctor has overtaken that title, but to diehard classic Who fans and those that just enjoy this more, this still is the definitive Doctor Who special. The Three Doctors may have pioneered the multi-doctor story, but the Five Doctors refined it to the point where, in my opinion, there hasn't been a better multi-doctor story. Now that I think about it, that probably confuses people since I just said that I like Day of the Doctor more, so I should clarify that I mean the Five Doctors is a better multi-doctor story than Day of the Doctor, but overall I think Day of the Doctor is a better story and anniversary special than the Five Doctors. And there's so much rich history behind this story. Enough that I'll probably be making a whole video about it at some point rather than talk about it here. It should also be noted that before I get to the review, there are like 3 or 4 different versions of this special that have different cuts and special effects, and so on, so to be as pure as possible, I rewatched the original version as transmitted back in 1983. Suck it, Star Wars fans. Now let's talk about it. This is one of those Doctor Who episodes where it has a really great twist, so I won't be saying many major spoilers. Yes, I know this came out years and years ago, but there are probably Doctor Who fans watching this that haven't seen it, and I really don't want to spoil such a great twist for them. But the basic plot for this introduces tons of great lore into the Whoniverse. The basic plot is that each of the Doctors and their companions are time-scooped into the Death Zone, a sort of gladiatorial arena on Gallifrey that was banned long ago. They all must journey to the Tower of Rassilon to find Rassilon's tomb for hope of escape. Along the way, meeting Daleks, Cybermen, the Master, and more, they have to get to the bottom of who's done this. So let's do a bit of a character breakdown. First, let's talk about each Doctor. The first Doctor is played by Richard Herndl in this, because, of course, William Hartnell had passed away about 8 years prior. Herndl does a great job as the Doctor, though, and for the most part is able to capture Hartnell's Doctor well. Something you might notice while watching this is that he does kind of represent the era which he's from. It reminds me of everyone complaining that the first Doctor in Twice Upon a Time having those sexist jokes. There, I don't think it was handled really well, but there is kind of a subtle, if you aren't looking for it, sexist joke where the Doctor keeps implying that Tegan shouldn't be doing dangerous things and should be getting snacks and tea for everyone because she's a woman. It's not really that funny on its own, though that's not really how the joke's supposed to work anyway. It's funny seeing Tegan, this very competent and independent woman, reacting to him saying these things and getting angry. It's also funny seeing the Fifth Doctor kind of apologizing for him. I think it's handled better than in Twice Upon a Time, though some people say that they shouldn't do these kinds of jokes with the First Doctor at all. I've heard people say that this is because while the 60s was a sexist period of time, the First Doctor himself wasn't sexist in the classic series. Personally, I don't think I've seen enough First Doctor stories to be able to accurately say whether or not that is the case. Something I think is kind of weird is that the First Doctor ends up being the one that figures out the solution in the end and saves the day, and none of the other Doctors figure it out. I don't have anything against the First Doctor, but logically, shouldn't they all come up with the answer, or the Fifth Doctor do it? I'm just saying that the other Doctors should be wiser and smarter, right? Anyway, both Patrick Troughton and Jon Pertwee do a great job going right back into their roles, Patrick Troughton especially, it's like he never left. Obviously, Tom Baker isn't really in this. It's a bit of a shame considering he's so good, but it's understandable. He had just left the role 2 years prior after a 7-year run. He left because he was afraid of being typecast, so going back into it 2 years later would have been a little dumb. So they just used a couple clips from Shada and edited them to fit. The first clip they edited really well to incorporate it seamlessly, but the second clip they didn't even bother putting a special effect on the screen to show him coming back to Earth. And the scene overall just feels really jarring when it pops on screen. In fact, the editing on this isn't really that good. When there's a moment that's supposed to be shocking, the cuts feel really lazy. They should be sharper. And sometimes it feels like they just linger on a shot a little too long. Peter Davison was the current Doctor at the time, and I really like him as the Doctor. He was the first Doctor in the role that had the benefit of growing up with the show and really being able to be familiar with the role before going into it. And it shows. He's supernatural, and it's only helped by the great script by legendary Doctor Who script editor and writer Terrence Dix. The companions are really great here too, but before I talk about that, I want to quickly shout out my Buy Me a Coffee page. With Buy Me a Coffee, you can send a donation to the channel that's just the price of a cup of coffee. I'm not currently monetized, so if you enjoy the videos and want to support me, directly, go over to buymeacoffee.com/ColeHershowsky. There's also a link in the description and on my channel page. Again, that's buymeacoffee.com/ColeHershowsky. So the companions being back is great, but honestly, it's kind of weird because there's no actual reason why they're here. Without giving too much away, the doctors were put there for intellectual reasons. So why the companions are there too is anyone's guess. Tegan and Turlough get a pass because they actually went to the Death Zone with the Fifth Doctor, who wasn't time scooped like the rest of them. And the Brigadier gets one too because he was caught in the same time scoop as the Second Doctor. But Susan and Sarah Jane are both individually time scooped, and there's no real reason for it. But besides that, it's great to see the returning ones come back and play off the Doctors and other companions. Susan and Sarah Jane hadn't been back since their departure, though Sarah Jane was back for K-9 and Company, and the Brigadier had appeared previously in Season 20, but before that he hadn't appeared since Season 13 in Terror of the Zygons, which was filmed with Season 12 anyway. It was also a really cool idea to have other companions cameo as phantoms in the Tower of Rassilon. It does lead to a weird plot hole though, when the Second Doctor says that Jamie and Zoe can't be real because the Time Lords wiped their memories. Because later that same story, the Time Lords also made the Doctor regenerate, so it would be impossible for the Second Doctor to know that Jamie and Zoe's memories were wiped. This is one piece of evidence for a popular fan theory that says the Doctor didn't actually regenerate right after the War Games, called Season 6B, but that's the topic of another video. Anthony Ainley is the master in this, and he's great as usual. But the only issue is that he doesn't really do much. In early scripts, he was going to be the one that brought the Doctors to Gallifrey, but that was removed because it was too obvious. So he just kinda hangs around. The only things he does are giving the Fifth Doctor the transport to the Council, and helping the First Doctor solve the puzzle in the Tower of Rassilon. And even then, the First Doctor probably could have figured it out on his own. But overall, it's a great story with great lore, even if Rassilon does have a goofy mustache. But what do you think? Let me know in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe for daily videos on the franchises you love, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.